I met you in the summer when you left, it was cold. Said we loved one another, guess that we were wrong.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing and demoing this little guy right here. This is the T3 Whirl Trio Curling Wand Set. This is the thing that your favorite fashion vlogger on Instagram uses to curl her hair. I got this on Christmas of this year, and I've been playing around with it and testing it out ever since, and I'm here to give you guys the scoop on it. I'm here to tell you whether or not I think it is worth the money, and I'm also going to be sharing with you three different looks that you can create with these barrels, one per barrel. So essentially I'm just going to show you how each barrel styles my hair. Before we jump into the video, I do want to ask you to subscribe to my channel. I already have 10,000 subscribers, which is so exciting. I know it's a very small amount, but I really, really appreciate every single one of you. And thank you so much for all your questions and comments and likes, and just the support in general that I get from you guys is crazy and sweet, and I just really, really appreciate it. So anyway, without further ado, let's jump into the video, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So this pouch, which contains three barrels and a base. Now, the whole concept of this line is you buy a barrel and then you buy all of your bases separately, so then you can interchange them. So with the set, you do get three barrels and a base, and then also if you wanted to get additional barrels, there are a total of seven out there, so you could potentially add four more to your collection, but you get three with the set. This is the base right here, and this is what you hold onto when you're curling your hair. You get the 1-inch barrel right here, which is the undone waves according to the website. I'm going to show you what my hair looks like when curled with this barrel, but like that's the name of the curls that you get with this 1-inch barrel. You also get the 1.5-inch barrel, which on the website is called the loose waves barrel, and you also get a tapered barrel from 1¼ inch to 3/4 inch, and this on the website is called tussled waves, and this is what I used to get my hair ready for this video. And last but not least, you also get this glove here in the pouch and in the set. I've never actually used this glove personally, but if you like to have this on when you're curling your hair, it is in the set. So just a little heads up there. So the set costs $270, which is really expensive for most of you guys, including myself. It's just an expensive product for sure, but you're essentially getting three different curling wands. So you kind of have to think about it that way. Now, if you get everything separately, not as part of a set, but like if you just buy it individually online, the base costs $100 and each barrel costs $85. If you would have gotten it separately, you would have paid $85 more than if you get the set. So essentially what you're doing is you're getting one of these barrels for free because you're saving $85 by getting the set. So that's the reason to get the set as opposed to getting all of these individually, because yes, you can totally just get the base and get one of these barrels. You don't have to get the set, but you're essentially getting a base and three barrels for the price of a base and two barrels. You're getting one barrel for free, which is not a bad deal, as long as you're going to be using all three of these barrels, and you're going to decide that by the end of the video, because I'm going to show you what each barrel does to your hair. And I think all of them actually are really nice barrels. I think that they're all very usable for most of you guys out there, but again, it's a decision that you're gonna have to make after you see how they curl my hair. Now, I did get this set at Christmas. My mom got it for me. Thanks, mama. And she paid, I believe, $200 for it. Like, it was a case of me finding it and being like, hey, mom, I really want this. It's on sale. This is what I want for Christmas. So anyway, she found this and she paid $200 instead of $270. And actually, I don't think I would have asked her to get it for me if it was $270 with no discount. I think that was 25% off or something like that. So if you're gonna get the set, I do highly urge you to get this with a coupon. I say coupon. I know. $200 for the set is a lot more reasonable than $270, I think. I also got the hair dryer recently, the Cura hair dryer. I really like it, and I did get it on a sale at Sephora. I think I saved $50 off of that one, and it was 25% off actually if you do the math, because normally it's $200 and I got it for $150, so it's 25% off. So yeah, $25 I think is like their like good standard discount that you can get off of things, and I highly urge you to wait and get it with a discount, because paying $200 for three essentially what you're getting is three curling wands is a lot better than paying $270. Like, to me, $200 is reasonable for three items like that, like high-end items, but $270 is like pushing it. So anyway, I like the fact that it's really well designed. I mean, look at how beautiful and stylish this product is. It's also really comfortable to use. It has a nice handle. You don't have like buttons that you accidentally press to turn it on or off or change the heat setting. The barrel is nice and long, so you can wrap even like longer hair around it enough times to create whatever look you're trying to go for. This thing right here swings nicely, so you don't have the cord wrapping around itself multiple times and gets all coiled and annoying like that. It's just a really well designed product. It's beautiful, it's easy to use, it styles your hair really well, the curls last for a long time. I love the fact that it has a heat setting option right here, which goes from 260 all the way to 410, so it gives you like a really low setting but also gives you a really high setting. So whatever your hair type is, whatever your hairstyle is, you can kind of like play around with it and do whatever is best for your hair and whatever is best for the hairstyle that you're going for. It also heats up really fast and it cools down pretty fast as well. It heats up faster than it cools down, but it does both fairly fast. These barrels also have the T3 single pass technology, and I'm gonna read you what the website says about that. The Whirl Trio is enhanced with intelligent digital, I can't say that word, digital technology to work in one pass. An internal microchip controls temperature fluctuation, ensuring even optimal heat. It is the start to a beautiful finish. Very marketing-y. T3 single pass technology is essentially a microchip that sits inside of this product and controls the heat temperature fluctuation to ensure that the heat is even at all times and there's not moments of like really high heat and really low heat, which makes sure that you don't burn your hair but also curl it and all of your curls are even. And it also saves space by not having to kind of have multiple bases when you don't need them. You just have multiple barrels and one base, which I think is genius as long as the product is well designed and the ability to like take the bases off and put them on is fairly easy, which it is in this case. Essentially, you're saving space in your vanity if you have like a small amount of space in your vanity like I do. And also if you're traveling, it's great. You can bring a bunch of barrels and not have to bring a bunch of full-size curling wands. You can just kind of, you know, interchange the barrels and create different looks with a smaller product space, you know. All right, so before we jump into the tutorial of how I got these waves, I'm going to show you how to operate this guy right here. It's really easy, but it does take a bit of getting used to. The first time I opened it, I didn't actually know how to use it. Like, there's not that much to it. It's not like a computer or a rocket that you're trying to launch here, but still, like, it does take a little bit of introduction. So let me just do that for you really quickly. So let me show you how I interchange the barrels. Let me take this off right now. So you have the base and the barrel. You take your barrel and you align it with the base. You see three little marks there. You push it all the way in until it clicks. Then you have this ring right here, and then you also have this unlocked mark and locked mark, and then a dot. A dot's going to be above either the locked or the unlocked, and that represents whether or not the barrel is locked or unlocked. Makes sense, right? So in order to unlock or lock it, you just twist this ring right here and it clicks when it's locked or unlocked. So you see this dot is above the locked. That means the barrel is locked and you can't like pull it out. Now if you switch it over to the unlocked, that means you can take it out. And then again, you slide it in and then you twist this and then you're done. To turn it on, you just press this on button and it's gonna go on to the last heat setting. And if this is your first time using it, it's gonna go to the highest heat setting. To change the heat setting, you're gonna double click on this and it's gonna start flashing, right? And then every time you click, it's gonna change that heat setting, and then you're just gonna keep cycling through until you get to the right heat setting. So right now I have it on the lowest heat setting and it's gonna blink like this, slowly blink until it's done heating up. And in order to turn this off, you just press and hold the button here, which is the only button, and it's going to cascade down and turn all of the lights off. So that's how you know it's off, is all the lights are off. It's really easy to use, and most of the time all you're going to need to know how to do is just on, which is one click, and off, which is click and hold until it just turns off. And the most challenging part of using this is definitely changing the heat setting, which can be just, you know, the lights are flashing, you're just trying to figure out what it's doing really, but double click on it and then you're going to just keep clicking until you reach the right heat setting. But again, most of the time you're gonna set it to whatever heat setting you like it at, which for me is usually either 1 or 2, which is either 260 Fahrenheit or 310 Fahrenheit. Every time you turn it on, it's gonna go to the last used heat setting. So essentially you're gonna need to pretty much do it once and then you're done with it. Okay, so now that you've learned how to use this, let's jump into the tutorial of me showing you how I got these waves. The way I curl my hair with this curling wand is the same way I curl my hair with any other curling wand. There's really nothing new or groundbreaking here, but I still want to quickly share with you how I do it. Now, the way I curl my hair in general, just like the technique, is I split my hair in 2 halves and I move each half to the front, and then I curl my hair from the back, and then whatever piece I'm done with, I flip it over my shoulders, and whatever basically is on my back right there behind me is done, and then whatever is in the front is something I still need to work on. I set my curling wand to the second heat setting, which is 300 Fahrenheit, and I'm also using the tapered barrel. I'm gonna begin by taking a section of my hair from the very back. When people say like it's an inch section, I don't really know what that means, because like how can you tell how big or small this is, but like this is how much I would take. And my hair is a little bit thicker and harder to curl, so I take smaller sections. Your hair might be easier to curl and you can take bigger sections than me, so it just kind of depends on what your hair is like, but this is my hair type and what works for me. I usually curl my hair away from my face, so I twist it this way and then I just twist it until I reach almost the end of my hair. And then when I have like this much left, I usually don't actually curl it around the barrel. That way you get that kind of relaxed modern curl instead of a ringlet. And then I let it sit on the barrel for, it just depends how long, but I think I would say I let it sit on the barrel for about 5 seconds, 5 to 10 seconds, and then I let it go. Sometimes I just kind of like let it sit in this curled position, and then when I'm done, this is the curl. And then this will relax by the time I'm done curling the rest of my hair, so it's gonna be like more like this, but when you first undo it, it looks pretty curled, but it does kind of like relax in a matter of minutes. I also want to say that I take smaller sections from the top than I do from the bottom, because those are the sections that you can actually see. The bottom sections, you can see them for sure, but not like nearly as much as you can the top sections. So what I'm trying to say is I spend more time, do a little bit extra for the top part of my hair than I do for the bottom part. Also, this part right here, it does get a little bit warm, but it's not hot, so you can carefully touch it. And then there is a little like lip here that you can use to place this on a table as well. Like there is like a little thing here and then a thing here. So if you're looking at it and you're like, I don't see any way I can put this on a table, there's like a little thing right here and right here. They got you, don't worry. All right, I'm just gonna continue working with the rest of my hair.
I met you in the summer when you left, it was cold. Said we loved one another, guess that we were wrong. I met you in the summer, my love was out of control. I've been going crazy without you so alone. I met you in the summer. Without you, I'm just staring at my walls and talking to myself. Now and then I'll try to laugh, but I'll cry a bit as well. I was never any good at being away from you. I met you in the summer when you left, it was cold. Said we loved one another, guess that we were wrong.
So yeah, this is the final finished look with this specific barrel, and this is what my hair looks like from the front. Again, you could have slightly different results using this barrel depending on your hair type, your hair length, your styling method, how you curl your hair, like if you curl it away from your face or towards your face, or if you alternate that. So you can obviously have variations on this look, but this is roughly what your hair will look like using this barrel. All right, let me turn around and show you the back of the hair. I actually really like this barrel style. I didn't think I was going to. I don't usually like narrower barrels because they just don't really work for my hair type. My hair is very straight and hard to curl, and I just like to have bigger barrels that give you more of a body type of a look instead of like tight curls. But this actually works really well for somebody even with harder to curl straight hair. I also took the liberty of curling my hair with two other barrels. I'm not going to show you the process because it's exactly the same process except the barrel is different, but like everything else is exactly the same. So now let me show you what the hair looks like when curled with this 1-inch barrel. I really like this barrel as well. It gives you slightly curlier look. Again, it just depends on a lot of different things, so I can't guarantee that you're gonna get the exact same look using this barrel, but that's just the general look that I usually end up with while using this guy right here. That was the look with the 1-inch barrel. Now I also did a look with the 1.5-inch barrel. The 1.5-inch barrel is clearly a lot bigger than the 1-inch barrel, and I think this is gonna be ideal for those of you who, one, have longer hair, two, have straighter hair, or three, if you don't want an actual wave but you want to add some body, give your hair some movement, this is the perfect barrel to use because this will give your hair that slight movement, slight body, slight wave to it, but it's not actually going to make it wavy, if that makes any sense. Ultimately, I think that if you don't have a really good curling wand right now and you're really curious to try out the T3 curling wand set, I think it's a good set to try if you have the funds for it. I think you're gonna really, really, really love it. My tip to you, if you're gonna get this, and I do think you're gonna like it if you do get it, is to get it on a sale or with a discount. So I've seen 20% off, 25 I think. Make sure to use a really good coupon or coupon. I say coupon, but people that actually know how to pronounce that word make fun of me for saying coupon, but I'm just gonna continue saying coupon because it's cute. I hope you guys found this video helpful. Thank you so much for all your comments, questions, and support. I have 10,000 subscribers. Thank you so much, you guys, for subscribing. I never, ever, ever thought I would get to this point. I know it's a very small amount in comparison to a lot of other YouTubers, but for me, every single subscriber is like, woohoo, yay! I'm really, really thankful for all your questions and comments and support and likes and subscribes. So I genuinely do appreciate all of you, and it makes me so happy reading your comments. So hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks so much for watching this video, and I do hope to see you in the next one.